material part, not that much now. The another important part is, see, coaching institutes, they have different teachers for different components of the syllabus. And they teach you syllabus-wise, topic-wise. Okay? So you yourself don't have to put an effort in, you know, keeping track of the syllabus that you have, how much you have read and what is there, because they take care of it. Now, if we ourselves start keeping the exam syllabus in mind and then plan accordingly, start preparing topic-wise, that thing is also taken care of. So these two parts, number one, if we go and take materials, say, ask someone to get from Delhi, download from internet, or number second, if we keep syllabus in mind and prepare topic-wise, almost half of our job is done. So in that sense, it's not that required. I personally found, you know, the JEE that you have cleared, that is way tough and way difficult than UPSC Civil Service Examination. The reason is, आपसे मैकेनिक्स का कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं आता है, यू वुड नीड समबडी टू टेल यू हाउ टू सॉल्व इट, बट यहाँ पे ऐसा कोई डेप्थ वाला, ऐसा कोई टेक्निकल चीज नहीं है. यू आर रीडिंग हिस्ट्री, आपको पहली बार में याद नहीं हुआ, पांच बार पढ़ा, फिफ्थ टाइम यू विल टीच इट टू समबडी एल्स. ठीक है, ज्योग्राफी है, दिस इज जनरल नॉलेज, दिस इज यू नो व्हाट इज व्हाट वी आर सपोज्ड टू रीड एनीवे, व्हाट वी आर सपोज्ड टू नो इट. सो इट्स नॉट डिफिकल्ट दैट वे. So in that sense, मेरे ख्याल से coaching absolutely compulsory नहीं है. However, there is one thing that you can should definitely avail, that is test series, both for your preliminary examination as well as main examination. You can subscribe to one of the test series, किसी online, offline, write those tests. Test series helps you evaluate how well you have prepared, कितना आपने prepare किया है, कितना कम है, where do you stand in comparison to other people who are also competing in the examination. So it also helps you, revise things. So test series you should definitely join. But for other coaching, it's like it's easy or available to you. If you can, if not, then that's all right. Also.
Last two questions.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, is there anything you need to achieve further after getting civil second rank? I mean, like what? Is there anything you need to contribute to the nation after getting?
I think the biggest, this is unfortunate but yet a fact, the biggest contribution that we can make is by doing our job very honestly and earnestly. So as you know, I don't think a civil servant needs to go and set up a charity and start working and doing that, because there are a lot of people who would anyways do that. My job, my responsibilities are in itself so important that if I do those things honestly, that will themselves contribute a lot. So I don't think there's anything other than the work in first place that one should look after. The second part is, of course, one has to be open and keep on reading, because at the end of the day, the fact is exam qualify karne se koi insaan toh nahi ban jata, you are still the same person. Okay, then one has to read, one has to see what other people are doing, what is happening in, say, Rajasthan, what is happening in MP. Only then I can do something here and it's good in JMP also. So to learn from other different places with the idea that the work I am doing, I'll do that in a more efficient and better way, and I think that's the most important thing.
Good afternoon. गुड आफ्टरनून सर. सर, यूपीएससी के प्रिपरेशन को स्टार्ट करने का जो राइट टाइम है वो क्या होना चाहिए? जैसे मैं यहाँ फर्स्ट ईयर में हूँ, तो सेमेस्टर के एग्जाम को हैंडल करते हुए यूपीएससी की प्रिपरेशन मतलब उसके साथ साथ कैसे किया जाए? यही
अर्लीस्ट यू स्टार्ट, the sooner you reach. So jitna jaldi aap start kar sakte hain utna acha hai. Ab aisa nahi hai ki you have to start pehle din se hi aapko sab kuch padhna hai aur ek hi saal mein khatam karna hai. You can start with small things. For example, reading a newspaper. Even if you are in the first year, you can start reading a newspaper.
ठीक है
तो न्यूज़पेपर पार्ट बाय द टाइम यू आर यू हैव कंप्लीटेड योर 4 इयर्स योर करंट अफेयर्स पार्ट व्हिच इज अ मेजर पार्ट यू हैव ऑलरेडी बीन टेकन केयर ऑफ इसी तरह से यू कैन स्टार्ट रीडिंग विद बेसिक एनसीईआरटीज सो डोंट स्ट्रेच ऑन योर रेगुलर शेड्यूल दैट द कॉलेज हैज स्किप बाद जो आपके पास टाइम बचता है उसमें आप थोड़ा 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 करके पढ़िए बट मेंटेन ए कंटिन्यूटी सो न्यूज़पेपर एनसीईआरटी बुक्स या बेसिक जो है लक्ष्मी का है यू कैन स्टार्ट रीडिंग बट ऐसा नहीं करना है कि एक साल में ही आप एक 6 महीने में ही सब खत्म करना है इट्स जस्ट वर्क दैट वे धीरे धीरे करके
सो सर माय क्वेश्चन इज नॉट दैट मच रिलेटेड टू द एग्जाम प्रिपरेशन it is somehow regarding that you said that as a civil servant what we have to do is we have to uplift our society we can make changes in our society but then question pops up into my mind that although you had the second rank in UPSC exams you chose to go to Rajasthan as your cadre and not your home state where you could have
made I should really thank you for this question it's like I wanted yaar koi kabhi ye question mujhse puche but nobody ever asked see jab hum log cadre ke liye apply karte hain at the time of main examination wo jab log detailed application form that I was telling you wo fill karte hain usi mein we also give preference to states okay first preference second preference third preference my first preference was J&K second was Rajasthan third was but this you know the allotment is not only based on this every year you know there's a distribution of vacancies among different states for example this year there are probably three seats last year there were also three seats in my year there were only two seats and those seats are also distributed in the form of insiders and outsiders okay the idea is say for example this year there are three seats okay two of those seats are for outsiders means from other state than J&K and one seat is for an insider okay there's a ratio of some 1/3 to 2/3 that is maintained between insider and outsiders because this is an all India service people want that people from different states work in different states that's the whole idea the year 2016 my luck what would I say we had only two vacancies and both of those vacancies were outsider vacancies and then so that year there was no insider vacancy in J&K had there been even a single insider vacancy so I would have got J&K so my first choice was J&K for that there should have been an insider vacancy that year because there was not an insider vacancy so my first is gone my second choice was Rajasthan but there was an outsider vacancy in Rajasthan okay so I got into Rajasthan because of that outsider vacancy so it's not that I did not choose J&K and I chose Rajasthan it was because of the vacancies that year I got into Rajasthan but at the end of the day we are all India service it does not matter in which place we work even if say somebody is allotted to a different cadre there's a option of something called inter cadre deputation that you can take and you can avail and come to any other state say for example I'm in Rajasthan if you want to avail the inter cadre deputation after a few years I can come to J&K also so then there's also government of India people can take a deputation to government of India also right now I'm on deputation to government of India ministry of peace so then the then again you know in government of India you have an opportunity to not only work for one particular state but also work at a pan India level you work in policy making designing policies in implementing projects which have a impact not only for a limited geographical area but for the whole of it and the last thing which I would tell you जब हमारा कार्डर अलॉटमेंट हुआ था सो आई टोल्ड माई ग्रैंड फादर कि आई डिड नॉट गेट J&K आई गॉट राजस्थान सो ही वाज लाइक ओके इट्स ऑलराइट ही सेड सबसे ज्यादा अजर वहां पे काम करने में होता है जहाँ के लोगों का आपसे कोई उम्मीद नहीं है, उनका कोई नाता कोई वहाँ पे काम करते हो तो उसमें अजर और उसका सवाब बे है, बे मोर देन। अगर यहाँ पे तुम्हारे पास गरीब, आपके पास शायद ये है कि मैं कोई अपने आस पास के लोगों के लिए है, तो यहाँ पे आप उस शायद से करोगे, वहाँ पे आप खलूस से काम करोगे, तो उससे बड़ा मुझे लगता कोई मोटिवेशन। Now, sir, you are at the helm of affairs, mashallah. Sir, do you feel there are some differences or complexities while working with the administration or the prevailing conditions in achieving these goals, sir, which you have had in your mind? No, I don't think so. In fact, we have logon ne na bada ye politicians don't let you work. There was a time politicians were of a different breed. There was a को कुछ और चाहिए होता है। अभी there's so much of information and people have become so demanding कि अगली बार इलेक्शन जीतना है तो people know कि हमें काम कराना है, काम करना है। और काम तभी होगा if civil servant get sufficient space and enough independence to do work. In my own experience, I have a very small experience though, but you know, having been in the service, I have seen so many people who have done extremely amazing work, whether they were that was subdivision level or district level or state level or even national level. And every time they would just say this one thing, you know, if you want to make things right, if you want to do things good, there's nothing or no one that can stop. It is quite possible that, you know, there are 100 things, and out of those 100 things, there might be one thing, you know, one which you may face an obstacle or a challenge. But there are those 99 things which you could without anybody's, you know, interference or anybody's opposition. So, idea to yahi hai, you know, there are challenges, there are political challenges, there are technological challenges, there are social challenges. But exactly the reason why have there been, you know, no such challenges, even a chatbot or a simple robot have done the job. So, just because I don't think there's anything that stops a person from doing whatever he could.